When you ruminate, you get very anxious. Like your energy, I know it feels like spiraling mentally, but even the energy is, it's like circling, spiraling. It gets very busy and agitated. And it's very, very hard to connect to our higher self and our intuition in that state.
Hey everybody, this is your host, Jennifer Way, intuitive consultant. Welcome to the Self-Consciousness Podcast. I'm so happy that you're here because today's episode is seriously one of my favorite episodes that I've recorded of late. Today we have Ryan from rockthedivine.com, who's a dear friend of mine. She's been on the show twice already, so just get ready for an amazing show. We do have videos, so if you're watching this, hey! If you're not, you can go over to YouTube, and you can go over to Spotify and watch it there. I'll include links down in the show notes below. So you're really in for a treat today because what we're talking about is ruminating. And I think if you're already watching the show or if you have any experience in developing your own intuition, you can understand that ruminating can sometimes get in the way of that. It affects your energy. We go into about how it affects you, and there's some tips that you'll find inside about what you can do about it. So you're gonna love this. I'm so excited that you're here, and yeah, come on in. Hi, Ryan.
Hi.
Ooh, I hated that hello.
Hi. Oh, I love it. I love it. You can talk breathy to me anytime you want.
Samar. Hey, everybody. Oh. Welcome to the podcast.
Hi. Hi, everyone.
Everybody.
Hi. We're doing breathy talk.
If you're listening to this, please know that there is a video available on YouTube and Spotify as well, where you can watch us.
Yay. You can see us.
Breathily. Is that a word? Breathily.
It is now. It is now. Yeah. Watch the video because I put on makeup. I do have on my pajama pants, but I wore a nice shirt so you can see the top. Looks, it's like business on top, party in the bottom.
We are a personified mullet, the same thing. Yeah. Like feeling the same.
That's, I know, right.
I definitely arranged stuff in my background, so please.
Oh yeah, I hid the cat litter. It's over this way, so I'm like, I look like I'm in an office and not the cat litter room.
There's so much that goes into this, you guys have no idea.
Yes, exactly. So they always bless their heart, want more videos. And I'm like, do you know what I gotta do to get this video?
Love it. I know, it's a production. It's a, yeah.
It is, yeah. But it's worth it. It's worth it.
Oh, because it's actually a production. That makes sense.
Ah, yes.
Good job, television industry. You knew what you were doing.
Yeah.
Oh boy. Anyway, welcome to the show. This is your third time on the show.
Yes. Oh, I love it. I always look forward to it. It's so much fun. Usually with other podcasts, I get nervous, but because it's you and you're so fun and such a good interviewer and talker, I'm like, I just look forward to it. I love it.
Oh my gosh. And I love you and I love having you here. And I'm so happy. I'm just so happy that you're my friend.
Oh, and, me too.
And so we were talking the other day about, I think I was just really venting. And I just kind of realized how much I ruminate on stuff. And yeah. So we decided, everybody, we're going to talk about how to really, or ways you can help yourself when you find your mind doing the crazy spiral loops, when you're ruminating on stuff.
Yeah.
And I have a question for you. What does ruminating do to us energetically?
So there's a few things. I notice that when you ruminate, you get very anxious. Like your energy, I know it feels like spiraling mentally, but even the energy is, it's like circling, spiraling. It gets very busy and agitated. And it's very, very hard to connect to our higher self and our intuition in that state. And even though I knew rumination was bad, and my therapist lets me know that it's bad, when I saw what it was doing to my energy and what it was doing to my clients' energy, I'm like, oh, it's real bad, you know, and it's just impossible to connect. when that rumination is going on. Mm-hmm. And so that's where, you know, knowing that now makes me try much harder to not ruminate. And I say try because I still do, but it's like the awareness I'm doing it, or if I am struggling to connect, I'm like, God, why can't I hear my guides? I'll go, oh, you know what? All day I've been worrying about this. I've been worrying about that. So then that also takes the pressure I put on myself when I'm like, I'm not connecting. I'm a horrible psychic medium. I'm going to close my business and pack this shit in, you know, and there we go, ruminating. But anyway, that's when I'm like, okay, you're just having a day and you're worried. And if you're trying to connect to your team while you're doing this, it's not going to happen. So put a pin in it, try again tomorrow.
Yeah.
You know,
oh, that's such a great answer. I definitely feel like, like there's an overwhelm. And I had a thought that I feel like one of the things that I can do, or this was the kind of, you know, when talking to spirit after our conversation, there was a couple of things that came up for me that I thought were interesting that I wanted to share. And one of them was just kind of pausing once you catch it in that awareness and, you know, do whatever you can to kind of root and ground. I think those are the typical answers.
Yeah.
But the thing that came up was kind of, especially for me, to ask myself, am I avoiding a feeling? Is there something I'm avoiding?
Yes. Yeah, I think that we're trying to avoid sometimes, I mean, it's situational, but usually I'm trying to avoid a problem. Mm. Like I was told years ago by my therapist, I was a fixer. And now I try to use that empoweringly. I'm like, well, I'm a fixer. So like, I don't think it was meant that way, but I grew up and was taught sort of subconsciously or accidentally that if anything bad happens or anything doesn't go right, it's my fault. So now as a 43-year-old, I'm still trying to avoid that. So I tend to go in the future, create the problem. And, you know, I got to say this, being a psychic, I do know what the hell's going to happen sometimes. Now, not all the time, but you know what I mean? Like you sort of do get a sense of what could happen. And instead of sometimes just letting that play out, I want to fix it here and now so it does not become a problem. So it's like a form of control. You know, I think it's almost always a form of fear or control, and maybe fear from, you know, or control from fear, I should say.
Yeah.
What do you think happens when you're doing that? Like when you're going around?
Oh my God. It's interesting because I always used to think that when I speak, it's just what's happening in my brain anyway. So that I have to kind of like, it's almost like I've got this balloon that I have to like let out the air. And when I talk, I'm like, oh, okay, I can sort of, because the pressure like builds up and all those things happen. But I find that I'm doing that. Well, apparently I'm not doing it a little less, but I find that, wait, what was your question again? I was ruminating and I...
That's okay. Track. What the hell was my question? Oh, like what do you think you're doing? Like, what are you trying to control something? Is it just being worried, fearful?
Yeah. So for me, it is an anxiety thing. Well, let me run this through. Let me figure out my options. And I rationalize to myself that what I'm doing is a good thing. Cause I'm thinking through all the possibilities.
Yes.
But then I get distracted by one of them and that will just go somewhere else. And then I'll do that and go there. And it's just like, brah, it's.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. I feel like too, I noticed that sometimes it's worse than other times, my rumination. And I feel like if I'm not taking care of myself, if I've been having too many drinks, too many days in a row, if I haven't gotten outside, like there's times I can see it's been worse for longer. You know what I mean? And then it's like, once if I let it keep going like that, it just spirals and spirals and spirals and gets worse. So I'm really trying as I get older to be much more aware of not letting it get so bad.
Yeah. Do you find that there's an element of hesitation out of the fear? Like, So I'm, it's really, it, maybe it's like I'm ruminating, but there's, it's really like this hesitation that I'm feeling. So maybe I can go into my head and explore it that way.
Yeah. I mean, I think that's a good point. I do think that it's, I think it's like it's trying to solve things with your brain. And that's usually not possible with most things. You know, it's like, it's not a math problem, and it's not like you're making a grocery list in your head where you could actually use your head for certain things. It's like, you're, you know what I mean? It's like yeah, there's certain things that just cannot be solved mentally. And I know that, but it's really in my blood to try to do it anyway.
Yeah. And I think it's also really, sorry about that. Not sure where we left off. We're just having all these like technological issues
today.
Oh
my gosh. We are always facing the worst problems with electronics and things. I don't know why.
I really like, I think after this, I'm going to ask like, what the hell, you guys? Like, why does this always happen?
Yeah. Yeah. Cause it's like the Zoom on my computer. I use it all the time and then it will not let me with you. It's like, no, we're going to make this hard. We're going to make you work for it.
We're going to have to work for it. And I believe that it's worth it. I know
it is worth it. Yes, it is.
Well, so one of the things that that came to me when I was asking my guides about kind of like, well, what else can really help with the ruminating?
Yeah.
Because I was doing and you and I had spoke about this. I was doing like a nature walk, which is just like what I try to do every day. Okay. 3 times a week, but I try to do this long nature walk and I try to get like my 6,000 steps, but I'm realizing I need to do more. So I was like, okay, but I find myself not being in nature. Yeah. I find myself not like looking at the tree, or I felt myself starting to ruminate. And there were also a lot of distractions because it's a city park. So there's like, there's like sounds and people like talking on the phone while they're walking and things like that. But one of the things that they said was change up the routine.
Yeah, so that's good advice.
Yeah, I was like, thanks, you guys. So I decided to take a new route and then just to engage more in that, in my body, and kind of be
sure,
you know. So and it really helped. Like I was looking for something new.
Yeah, your curiosity will make you present. Yeah. So that's really, gosh, they always have such good advice. I know. You know what
Damn,
I mean?
Like, guys.
And sometimes we don't ask them. It's funny being an intuitive, because I think people think we're always like asking everything about anything and everything. And we don't, you know what I mean? Like I don't know why, but we don't. Like, we're just being regular people and going, geez, I don't know why. You know, and then I'm like, oh shit, I guess I could ask them. I do have that skill set. They will tell me, you know?
Yeah.
And then it's so easy. It's so, do you ever notice the advice they give you is completely, usually easy to understand, down to earth, almost like, duh, why didn't I think of that? It's never really this complicated answer. Mm-hmm. And I think a lot of people discredit it because it's not. They think, well, that's too easy. It's got to be way, way, way harder, you know?
Because we're so used to things being harder.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's everything's so heavy.
Yeah.
But they're just kind of like, you're fucking it up. You know,
just take a walk down another street.
And you're like, what? Okay. So, yeah. So that definitely seemed to help. And it brought a little bit of excitement back to the activity that I was doing.
Sure. Yeah.
Which was, it was really insane.
You know, I think too is, and I know I do this myself. I think we, like when you're on the walk, you probably thought to yourself the whole time you needed to be present and not ruminating. So then when you weren't able to do that, it wasn't successful. And from what I understand, the guides never expect that. They know it's an impossibility as a human, you know? So it's like, were you able to be present some of the walk? Were you able to go, oh, I noticed I'm ruminating. Okay, I'll kind of come back to my breath and look at that tree. And then your head will go again. It's like, that's why I teach people with meditation. It's like, they feel that if they haven't done 30 minutes of no thinking, it was unsuccessful. And I'm like, there's Buddhist monks up in the hills right now that have done this for 50 years that can't do that. And they're not trying to. That's the difference. You know, like they're not like, oh, I was thinking. That's they accept the thoughts as they come in. They just don't let them take them with them. And it's like, that's what I think you and I have a tendency to do sometimes more than others. It's like the thought can really take you if you let it. So it's like the thought's going to come in, but you have some control of where you go with it.
Yeah. You can notice it and then be like, oh, I was doing that. But you're right. That's another tip. Basically, don't worry about ruminating too much. It's almost like counterintuitive in a way, but it's like, no, it's actually.
Yeah. You can ruminate about ruminating. Yeah. You know, like we can do anything. I mean, we can just take anything and just totally just make it so crazy. Oh, sorry. I'm swearing. I'm sorry.
We're swearing encouraged. Not
okay, good. Because it's in my, that's also my blood. It's very hard for me not to. But yeah, it's like, we can take something and just, I can only imagine what the guides are thinking sometimes, like, oh my gosh, girl, like chill out, you know?
I'm like,
and I notice my guides will get, oh, I'm sorry to interrupt.
No, that's okay. Go ahead.
I noticed that my guides can be a little stern with me at times, and it's, trust me, it's needed. If I'm really ruminating over something, and it can be something stupid. I mean, I'll ruminate if I'm picking out the right fridge. I'll go, will you tell me the right fridge? Was it Samsung? Was it LG? Okay, I'm going to give you four options, because I don't want a stupid fridge. You know what I mean? And they'll kind of go, yeah, you know, Samsung would be all right or whatever. And I'm not satisfied though that we talked about it once. We're going to not only beat this horse, we're going to light it on fire. We're going to smash it. We're going to throw the ashes around. I mean, like, it's just, there's going to be no horse whatsoever when I'm all said and done. They'll go quiet on me. They'll go, okay, now we're done. Now you're done. We're done. And I'm learning. I've gotten better at it. I used to try to push against that. And it's like, you know, it's like hitting a wall. There's just no intuitive information coming in. And you get so blocked. And I'm getting better at noticing that feeling and going, okay, I gotta stop. So that again shows you the energy, like, of what happens with this ruminating and asking questions repeatedly. And my clients and I have the fear of being wrong, which I think that's where rumination comes from too. And so it's like your guides will try to teach you a lesson of like, hey, sometimes you just, is it wrong or is it just something that happened and they can experience, like, just go forward and don't worry so much if it's right or wrong. You know,
they have to remind me all the time.
Oh
my God.
You know?
Yeah. It's like, there isn't a wrong way. There's just an alternate path. You know,
yeah.
but I think we're also like, we don't want a detour.
we want it to be straight path. Easy.
Yeah.
We didn't come here for that. And I know that. And I shove it down people's throats, but yet I'm still like, I just don't want a bad refrigerator. You know, I don't want to deal with a freezer breaking.
I know. And watch you get the perfect one. And because that particular one has like a weird bum, like, coil in it or whatever, it happens to be the one that like breaks down.
Yeah.
Like, that shit happens.
That happened to me. They helped me pick out this refrigerator. I wasn't using an example. I was being super serious. They did help me pick out this. Things were great. And then things took a shit quickly with the freezer. And I was like, you gotta be kidding me. Long story short, it was a defective door. So like, we got a new door. It was free. You know, everything worked out. Trust. I mean, we had to have someone come fix it and all this stuff. But I'm like, I was almost having an anxiety attack about it. I was so disappointed in myself. Like, every time I think, I've come so far, I'm enlightened, blah, 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 the hell I am. You know what I mean? Like, I'm like, this refrigerator is going to kill me. I made it so much worse than it was.
Yeah.
Trying to control having any problems. And you know what's funny? I can tell my guides, like, they got the, well, the door got fixed. Everything's fine. Now I love it. And to them, they're like, see? Yay. And I'm like, couldn't I have just chilled out and like sort of use what I've been taught to like just be present, yeah. Deal with the everything as it comes. Don't get ahead of yourself.
See, you know? I feel like a part of you knew that something was going to break down and you didn't want to experience that. You just wanted it to be simple. And that's why you maybe, probably. I don't know, yeah. like wanted to probably. Ask them and be like, I don't want to have to go through this.
You didn't want to have to deal. And you know, like a lot of times, not only do I deal with my anxiety, I deal with my husband's. And that's not a criticism of him. I think anyone that's married knows, especially being a woman, you know, like you're going to deal with theirs too. And I was trying to avoid that because I talked him into getting a new fridge and you know what I mean? I just, yeah, I was trying to avoid problems.
Yeah.
And it's like, can't. Oh, and that's such like a, you know, I don't know, like, that's not really a problem. Yeah. Like that's where I get annoyed with myself too. I'm like, oh, your fridge broke, you know, like your house didn't burn down, you know?
Yeah. I mean, it's sometimes it just feels like a lot of stuff. I mean, I don't know about you, but I feel like we're both kind of like, like we're just so exhausted.
We get annoyed with ourselves.
We get annoyed. And yeah. I feel like but the more this kind of stuff happens, the less invested in the feeling of the end result.
Yeah, yeah.
Feel a little more like, of course.
Like, You're right about that. You're right. It's like these little milestones of even just being aware. Like, you ever look back and you're like, oh my God, I was being crazy. I know that some people don't ever even think that. And it's not a judgment on them, but you know what I'm talking about? Like, you know, people, they go through life, they would never have reflected and learned something like, okay, I didn't need to throw myself down a rabbit hole. You just had to call someone and get it fixed. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, I couldn't fix the refrigerator with my mind. See? You know what I mean? But I tried. I was like, okay, do I have this skill set? What is this skill?
I'm sure there's a YouTube video. I can figure it out.
I think so. There's a YouTube for everything.
Oh my God. Of course, now I'm like, oh, there was this guy I saw on YouTube that like, he like learned how to build his own house on like all through YouTube.
Oh, wow.
So it's like with possibilities like that, no wonder we ruminate, because then it's like, well, this guy built his own house just using YouTube. Like, why can't I?
Yes. But then it's like, you want to not have any problems. So you want this drywall and this flooring. Yeah. It's like, yeah. I should never build my own house. How's that? And my back couldn't handle that anyway.
Oh, God, no. Yeah. I mean, and then I'm also wondering, one of the things that maybe, I think for me, especially because I'm always sort of like looking out and comparing and mm-hmm. when, and that's one of the reasons why I had to leave Instagram, because I think I just took it. I take it in like a lot. So for me, like, I'm ruminating over what I'm seeing other people doing and what mm-hmm. I maybe feel like I need to be doing. And I actually just read this article, and I'm just going to pull it up right now. Pause, YouTubers and Spotifyers and everybody else. It was about thinking, and they actually did a study. Okay, this is a book called Thinking 101. There was an article in NPR recently, and the author is Woo-Kyoung Ahn. And she is I think she was doing research. I think she's a teacher at Yale. Look it up. You're good. You guys know how to do that. So she works in a field of psychology known as illusion of fluency. And there's a bias where we overestimate our abilities. Basically, I'll summarize it. So she did an experiment with her class where they showed a video of people of like K-pop, or it was BTS doing like dance moves together. Mm-hmm. And it was like simple dance moves.
And you know, they're practiced and all that stuff. And then she asked the class if anyone could redo those dance moves. It was a short clip. And some people were like, oh yeah, I can do it. It was easy. And not one person could do it.
Oh my God.
There's this like overestimation, but it has to do with when you see people doing something really well, you think you're affected by it because you think you can do it. Just, you can do the same thing. Like, oh,
that's interesting.
Yeah. She said, people can have overconfidence about what they can accomplish by watching other people do it so fluently.
That's a good point.
Yeah.
That's a good point. You know, a lot of the clients I have, well, I shouldn't say a lot, some, you're making me think now that, you know, a lot of times they're in a hurry to start a business using their abilities. And I'm wondering if some of it is what you just said, that they see all these people that have a lot of followers and they're doing their business seemingly well. And they're like, oh, well now I can, but it's like, they don't realize what it took to get from there to there,
yeah,
you know? And then when they really get into it, it's fucking hard,
yeah,
you know? And it takes time. You know,
so much time,
and you're not going to be, you have your own unique magic. And if you're trying to copy someone else's, then you're not really using your, you know what I mean? And then you know, it won't necessarily come natural because it's not yours.
It's not yours. And it wasn't meant to come through you like that.
Mm-mm. No,
it's so hard to remember that. And we yeah. try to talk ourselves out of it.
Yeah.
The spirals.
And some of us are not meant to have that level of success, but that doesn't mean our success is less, mm-hmm. you know? And I think my guides, when I was first trying to have a business, of course I did that. I compared to everyone who looked like they, you know, knew what they were doing. And
yeah.
I thought I was failing because I hadn't reached that, like in 3 weeks, you know what I mean? I'm like, it's been 3 weeks. I've been on Instagram and I only have like 10 followers. But it took me a while to realize, you know, when I just said, fuck it, I'm just going to be Ryan and we'll see what happens. Then all of a sudden it went, psh. Yeah. And I thought, you know, and then even like, I was still wondering if I should be more out there, more successful. I'm talking like TV psychic kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Cause I look up to so many psychics that do have TV shows or are on TV shows. Like that's always been so interesting to me.
Yeah.
And my guides sometimes are like kind of shaking their head. And one time they even told me, I don't remember what I asked exactly, but they were like, you would get really nervous and be very overwhelmed. And I was like, I would be. Thank you for saying so. You know, like they know our temperament, they know our energy, they know what makes us nervous. So I thought, isn't that funny? I just should have maybe asked a little sooner what they were thinking, but they will only tell you at this point, you know what I mean? So it's like, they won't say, well, you're never going to be successful, you know, or you're never going to have 20 million followers. I don't, you know, it's like the future hasn't been created, but I think they'll say at this point, don't get ahead of yourself. But at this point, this is what we think you're comfortable with. And then I think if we ask them sooner, you could really take off a lot of pressure that we're putting on ourselves.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. You and I had talked about that too, about being like literally being a vibrational match and to yeah. something, to an outcome, and being honest with yourself if you're a vibrational match to that.
Yeah.
If you're feeling it. And, you know, maybe forcing it forcing the feeling of it, you know, in that kind of manifestation way, it's maybe that's why sometimes it doesn't work, because you're really yeah. just not a vibrational match. And unless you really know how to get yourself into that space and live that, it can be yeah. challenging, and it can be disappointing, and it can also make people be like, oh, fine, I'm never doing this again. You know?
Well, you know, what's interesting is that who wants what, you know what I mean? Like when people almost have to ask themselves when they're ruminating or questioning, like, why don't I have this? Or why aren't I successful? Why do you want to be like, do you think your spirit and your soul has come here to do certain things?
Yeah.
Or is it your ego? Yeah. And then it's like, if your ego's trying to steer the ship here with stuff, it's not, you know what I mean? Like that you're always going to be fighting against something that's not meant for you necessarily. Like your spirit, I think, has a lot more fun if you let it. It's not so worried about outcomes. Oh God, I need to write this down.
It's okay. We're recording it.
Take notes. You know, like, yeah. But you know what I mean? And I think that's the rumination too. I think when I'm ruminating or worrying about something, which folks happens most days, honestly, really, I could tell you, you know, I do it with the littlest of things sometimes. This is not very fun. You know what I mean? It's like, then I think that's a sign to me, like, hey, you're not having any fucking fun. How fun is this? You know what I mean? Like worrying like what concealer you're going to get because Sephora offers 77,000 and you're like, but, and my guides are like, you can send it back. God damn it. You know,
there's an overwhelm. I feel like a lot of times ruminating is the answer to navigating overwhelm, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. Afraid to pick the wrong thing, afraid to do the wrong thing. And you have so many choices now because of the internet. And yeah. I mean, just so much exposure. Like there's, you know,
being influenced by influencers who are influencing to yes. influence you.
I watched a whole video last night about this one tinted moisturizer. And then at the end, the girl's like, well, I have really dry skin. And I'm like, this was a waste. I have oily skin. I watched this whole 20-minute video. I've wasted 20 minutes of my life. But yeah, you can like, you now, you know, I think years ago, like probably when my parents went shopping for a refrigerator, they were like at Sears Roebuck and they're like, there's two. One's green, one's orange.
One's orange. They're 70s. Yeah.
And you just picked one. Yeah. And like now it's like we have so much and like now we can't make decisions.
Yep.
Because what if it's the wrong one?
It's the wrong one. Mm-hmm. I mean, and like orange refrigerators. I mean, that was.
Yeah. Those son of a bitchin' things lasted forever though.
They did.
They're still in people's garages with beer in them.
Yeah.
This one, I'm lucky if this thing will last 3 years, you know? So it's like, what magic were those things made out of?
I remember learning about something in college, side note, called perceived obsolescence. And it was a literal marketing strategy and production strategy for making cars. And it's been sort of carried through in most products where they could have made cars to last forever.
Yes.
They chose not to.
Yes.
It was not to, so that you're dependent on buying new parts or buying new cars, because how yes. else are you going to keep things going? So everything is just breaking down.
Like, yep. They've gotten extreme with it. I had one of my art teacher's friend's job was to break toasters. I don't know what company he worked for. This is back in the 90s, but he had to create the toaster to last so long before something would go awry. So then they'd buy a new toaster, you know? Yeah. Tricky.
Guys, yeah. Seriously. It's, you know, so, and oh, it just, I'm like, I'm not.
And then I'm trying to
car.
Ruminate, you know, think about there. I'm trying to control why some like engineer is in a lab right now going, okay, Ryan's refrigerator is going to malfunction at 4 years and 3 months. And she's going to drive herself nuts asking her spirit guides, when's this thing going to take a shit so I can be prepared? Isn't it amazing? This stuff, like we,
this is the shit that we have to live with. It's like,
yeah. Yeah. My guides are, even though I do want to say this first, no, the guides are so happy to talk to us. They don't care what you talk about. So I want to say that first. Okay. Cause some people come to me and they think they can't ask little things. And I'm like, no. The divine's part of every part of your life, not just big stuff. Having said that, on a funny note, we're given these gifts and in this lifetime have decided to be able to use them, can talk to 12th dimensional beings about all kinds of shit. And I'm like, hey, should I get an LG instead of the- or a KitchenAid? I don't know. And they're like, that's what you want to know today. All right. Okay. Well, let's go with the KitchenAid, Ryan. And by the way, when will the planet blow up? What year do you think that's
going to be? How did we get here? What does it all mean? Why does my cell phone fuck up? Like, when? Why can't they make phones that can fall into water? I mean, it's just,
Yeah. They must just, I think that they think it's funny. You know, they love us regardless, but.
They better. Yeah. Girl, yeah. I know we're providing so much entertainment for them. They really.
Yeah, I hope so. That's for sure.
There's been more than a couple of times this week where I'm like, hope you enjoyed that. You know, good job.
We're like, yeah, we're definitely laughing, you know. Like, you know, I wanna say this too. You know, from all the conversations that we've had, that I definitely have problems sometimes with kind of icky things like lower beings and things like that. And I wanna say that sometimes that stuff has bothered me because of my rumination. So that's another place where, like, your energy can really pull in things. And it doesn't have to be something like that. It could be like, you know, I don't know, you're so afraid of getting in, or you're so afraid of tripping. Let's say that you're going to be at a wedding. You're like, don't trip. And then you take a nosedive. Did you maybe pull that towards you because you were going around and around? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So it's like, you know, that rumination, that energy, it has a strong pull to it. And it's not necessarily a good one. You know what I mean? And it's like when you're ruminating about like finding someone or like falling in love and you feel like maybe you have to be with someone. Well, can you imagine if you're really obsessed and really always thinking about it, what are you pulling in? Yeah. You're probably not pulling in like a great person.
Yeah. That's not, you like know, a like your energy's not match. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So it's like, again, it's like, we have to really be aware of, I don't like the spiritual guru people, teachers that are like, monitor your thoughts and don't think bad things and be aware of your thoughts. It's like, come on. No. Don't do that. But the truth to that though, is I do think we need to be aware of our energy and sort of learn to go, okay, yeah, no, I have been ruminating. I'm going to, instead of trying to control my thoughts, which is impossible, I'm going to do something more constructive.
Yeah.
With my energy for a little bit, try to get myself out of that cycle.
I feel like it's like filling up a bathtub with water and it just stays there. And you're just like, okay, now it was nice and hot and like now it's cold. And mm-hmm. When the truth is, it just needs to go down the drain. It just needs to go directly from the faucet down to the drain. I mean, that's really not a great analogy, but
no, it
but
is.
Like, that's I kind think of how I picture it in a way. It's like, we're going to leave it in this tub because we need the water, but
and it's not going to stay the same. It's not going to stay the same. At some point, like, why isn't it warm anymore?
Yeah.
And it's not going to get warm.
It's not, you know, because it's already like, you're trying to capture it, but it can't be captured. Or like maybe like an electric circuit, you know, you've got that sort of thing that throws off the connection. If I knew more about electric, I should study these things, but and of course they're like, you don't need to study it. You can, you know, ask about it, but it's like, you've got your things that are connecting and if they're not, then the energy is just not going to flow through. So
exactly.
Yeah. It's almost like a tightening up it's like a winding up. So I always think of energy. Energy is like that spiral and, you know, it has to, it's winding anyway. So naturally our energy is doing this, but when we are contracting, it just becomes this, you know, it's sort of like, maybe it's just running around in that same loop and it's not.
So many things happen to your chakras from that. And, you know, I think if people would tune in or could actually see like what's going on, they'd be like, oh, I thought I was just thinking. And it's like, look what it's doing. You got shit flying at you. Your energy's all out of whack. your energy field's now got holes in it. I mean, like there's so, it can get so deep, you know, that like of the stuff that happens, it's like, I wonder if we could send everyone out diagrams and going, you think you're just overthinking, but look at the mess, you know, and it feels that way. Do you notice like you don't feel well when you're ruminating? You just don't.
And it, I feel like it's, I think it's probably a big source of stress for people.
Oh my God. To me, it's one of the greatest suffering we put on ourselves. And, you know, I'll catch myself doing it. And sometimes I talk to myself, like, I got a roommate and she's a crazy bitch. And I'll hear like, you know, your brain is just doing what it's supposed to. It likes to be busy. And it's going to keep trying to be busy, but it's like, we don't have to be so attached to what it's trying to do over here. So sometimes my brain will say something even stupid, like something I don't want, something I don't think, you know, it just says something like, hey, drive off that bridge. And I'm like, but I don't want to die. So why'd I think that, you know what I mean? Yeah. And I'll just look now. I say, look, I feel like she's on the left of me, my, this crazy bitch, but oh, was that good? Did you get it all out? Like, you feel better now? Like you're saying weird shit, you know? And then I notice sometimes treating that weird part of my brain like that helps, because then I can just go back, like, you know, focus away from it instead of going, oh, what was that? What did you mean? What's going on? What's wrong with me? Like, you know,
you can, I think it's helpful to be able to kind of sort of put it in a little box for a second.
You know?
I don't think I think you're acknowledging what that energy is and that it's a part of yourself, but you're also observing it. So you can sort of not separate from it, but just recognize that.
Yeah. It's not so
got
attached.
Its own agenda. Yeah.
Well, you're right, because the brain, I don't understand this fully. Do you notice the brain will try to scare you?
Oh yeah.
All the time.
Yeah.
And it's like, I've even said to my head, you can be a little more helpful here. Like, let's be, you know, like you have all these resources and tools and experience, like be helpful. Don't just say and think weird shit.
I know. It feels like a some kind of survival mechanism. You know,
I think
like
you're right.
Maybe an old thing, you know, everyone always talks about like lizard brain or whatever, but I mean, I think you're right. I mean, our brains want to work. Our brains are constantly working. And I feel like we need to, like, they have to be fed, you know? And if they're not eating the proper nutrition, almost in a way, just in terms of like what's stimulating for you, for your consciousness, what helps the whole body work together. Like the brain will recognize something it wants to do, and then the whole body will come together and do it. And I always feel like when it stops here, that's when like anxiety starts, and that's when it just doesn't get a chance to really like process through. So like, I feel like thoughts are feelings almost in the same way, that if we have to allow them to process through to a degree and recognize where we're just kind of flooding or, you know, we're just kind of going, because I think with feelings you can go around in a loop as well.
Oh sure.
I mean, your thoughts are directing that, of course, but the feeling, like if you're crying about something and then you keep thinking about it, and then you're like, and then you're better, and then you're like, because you've like already like brought it back around, you're like, let me try a little more.
But yeah, like I want to my brain likes to redo arguments. Do you know what I mean? Like, or not anything, a conversation, we're going to go back over it. And I can see myself doing it. And I'm like, okay, we already lived this. You know, you want to do it again. You want to get pissed off again. Like the ego, you notice it's like, it just wants to go back over and go back over. And I do yell at myself and I'm like, okay. Where my younger self, you know, I didn't have the awareness. So I would just keep circling something, where now I'll start to, and then at least I can go, I see what you're doing, you know, like it's sort of amazing. I think it wants to keep us safe. So if it keeps replaying something, it can, I don't know, again, try
maybe
to
like
be,
make sense of it, because we need a, like I my therapist who I love, she's like, the brain needs a map. The brain needs to know where to go. And if we're not, if there isn't one, then it naturally is probably going to keep like looping around in circles.
Yeah, it's like, well, I'll do this instead because you're not giving me, you know. You know what I wonder too? I think sometimes, like I had said earlier, when I have, if I've not been taking care of myself, my rumination gets bad. I think sometimes people need to recognize, instead of playing into the rumination, stop a second and go, oh, wait, what's this trying to tell me? Like the rumination is probably a symptom of something.
Absolutely.
You know, and yeah. So then that can, it can be something as simple as like, man, I haven't been outside in 2 weeks, yeah. You know, and I'm ungrounded, or yeah, I'm just really scared of what's going to happen with something. And just that acknowledgement, I think sometimes helps like the brain chill out a little bit, you know. You simply cannot, and the reason I'm saying it again is because it comes up so much, and even for myself, you cannot connect to higher vibrations and deep intuitive guidance from that state. You just can't. And that's why I push meditation on people.
Yeah,
because it's like you need to get a handle on this, you know, like you maybe you're not going to master it. Maybe in our last lifetime, we're like, I guru'd it. I'm enlightened. I'm a master. You know what I mean? But it's like, don't worry about that. You know, cause I have so many people that they don't meditate and they're like, well, I can't turn my brain off. And I'm like, you need to educate yourself on what meditation is then, because the fact that you're saying that tells me you don't know enough about it. Like I can't turn my brain off either.
No one can turn their brain off. It's not about emptying of thoughts. Yeah. No. It's about, I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, but I feel like it's about being able to focus in your thought, your energy mm-hmm. into one thing without sort of letting it waver too much. But it's, again, if it does, just noticing it and bringing it back, sort of like, just noticing what comes up.
Yeah. You're becoming like the brain's not running you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And a lot of times for most of us, the brain will run you. And then the brain also, you know, will make you feel like you were running from a bear all day, you know, like it's very powerful. So it's like, this is just trying to flip the power here. Like, okay, my brain's going to do its thing, but I'm not so attached to what it's telling me and circling around. And, you know, even if it's just the rumination, it's like, I know every time I catch myself doing it, I'm like, you're trying, you have a control problem. You have a lifelong control problem and you're now trying to control something mentally, you know. But and again, tomorrow I'll say it again to myself.
Of course you have a control thing. Of course. I mean, it's like, I always feel like, you know, it's especially right now with everything so out of control, it's very hard to feel safe in like, oh, such a wavy world.
Yeah.
And control is such a common thing, you know, like control yourself, control your emotions. It's such a widely accepted theme in the world. Yet we also discuss how like, oh, we know we're not supposed to be controlling, you know, or feel like over controlling, but it's like everything in the world is about control.
Mm-hmm. I mean,
the wars are about control. Businesses are about control. Even like the railroad strike, who's got control over, you know, it's just such a huge theme in being human right now in this time and space. So it's like, don't beat yourself up too much, because it's like, Of course we want control, because it's scary being out of control.
Yeah.
It's scary not knowing what's coming. And maybe that's where the guides do come in. It's like, we gotcha.
Yes.
You know, and to kind of trust that. And it's just the hardest thing, you know, like sliding down a water slide. It's like, where's this leading? And you just have to kind of be like,
yes, that's a good analogy. It's true. And they, you know, it's funny because we get so far ahead of ourselves and it's like, we're meant to be having fun and having these experiences. And a lot of them just have to play out. And we're always trying to not let that happen. And, you know, that's, you know, from having clients, a lot of times they're like, they very much tell me my future, tell me what's going to happen. And it's like, well, you're going to decide what happens.
Yeah.
They don't like that.
To do.
Yeah.
Yeah. This has been amazing, by the way.
Oh my God, shit. Yeah.
This has been such a great conversation. I feel like I love what we can make, you know, like, and I love hearing from you, and your perspective is fucking always on point. In my opinion, I am.
Well, that's nice. I have a lot of experience in ruminating myself. I'm a professional ruminator. My name is Ryan. I'm a professional ruminator. I'm here to talk all about ruminating.
What I was wondering? I was like, did that come from Rumi? Like, now I want to find the etymology of ruminating. I'm like, but isn't Rumi like a wise writer or something?
Yeah, I think he was a
philosopher, poet, maybe?
Yeah, something like that. Should know that.
I am smarts and brainy and stuff. My brain is like, you're not holding on to like information that could actually hurt you. So let's just think about all the other shit that, you know, word origin. Sorry, everybody.
I want to know this.
Chewed over. It's from Latin ruminat, meaning chewed over.
Oh, that's very fitting, isn't it?
Ruminate, a negative word. Ruminate can be used in both positive and negative ways. It can refer to thoroughly thinking something over or to overthinking it.
I hate
the word overthinking, because I'm always like, that's like, what are we supposed to underthink? Because it seems like that's more popular.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna go stick with ruminate. Yeah, I like that.
Good to know. Tell everybody what's going on and where to find you and all that good stuff.
You know, my website is rockthedivine.com. My Instagram is rockthedivine. And I also have a podcast. I haven't been on in a while, but I'm going to start that back up because it's fall. It's Turn On Your Light podcast. And pretty soon I will be taking on clients again. I take clients on seasonally. So I'm thinking in October, I will send out an email. So if you're subscribed to my email list, you will be updated with when I'm taking on clients. And it'll be soon, and I'm excited. I'm ready. It feels like it's been a long time, and people are so patient. Like, I don't know many business people that be like, well, I gotta take off 6 months every year and hope you stick with me, you know? And people have, though. I mean, they wait, and I'm really appreciative of it. If I could talk, I really appreciate it. Oh my God. Forget it. See, I should have had 2 cups of coffee. Now I'm just messing up my words.
I'm telling you, Mercury in retrograde, it ends October 2nd. I had to look it up before we spoke, because I was like, obviously.
Isn't there like 9 planets retrograding? My girlfriend told me something last night, and I was like, I'm like, that's gross.
This would explain the holding pattern that everybody is in.
Yes. Yeah.
Well, tell us about the courses that you have available.
Oh yeah. Thank you. I do have courses. If you go to my website, you click on the tab that says online course. I do offer, I would call it a beginner's course. And there's 22 modules in there, and I've gotten really good reception from it. My energy only allows me to get to so many people. And so I wanted to create something that could really help people when they were at home privately, learn things that would take many, many sessions with me to get. So, you know, I came up with this, and yeah, it's great. It's done really well. And I hope more people are exposed to it. And a lot of people use that and then still later book a session with me. And what I like is that then they have questions from the classes that they took, and we can just dive right in, you know, and you don't have to do that, but it does sort of get you a little further ahead.
Yeah, I love it. And I think for everyone listening, the more you can do to develop your own intuition, the better off you're going to be. And it doesn't mean you won't ever need to work with an intuitive or a psychic again. It just means that, you know, you want to start the process to really learn how to trust yourself. And you're just absolutely so great at that, with the helping people develop their gifts.
Thank you. I really, if I would have had, and I'm not saying this just to sell it, but if I would have had what I offer in this course when I was first starting, I really feel it would have made so much difference. You know, I spent 3 years studying and working with mentors, which was great. But like, I could have moved much more quickly had I been given this information. And I didn't want people to struggle the way I did and scour the internet and just, you know, Jen, it's just, there's so much, there's too much. And a lot of it's not necessarily very helpful. And that's the clients that come to me. That's usually what's been going on. They've been to classes, they've done online things, they've had teachers, and it's not going well. They spend a lot of money. And so in one session, I'm able usually to get them focused. And they're like, oh my God, in one session, now I get it. And I'm like, yeah, that's what I want. If you only need me for one session, then I did my job, you know? And if you want to continue, I'm happy to do that too. But that's what this course I did, you know, I thought I'm just going to sit down. I'm going to start recording myself. With my little camera, and I'm just going to start sharing what I know, you know, what I've learned. And yeah, I hope it's helping people.
Oh my God. Well, you've helped me so much. And if anyone's watched the show before or listened to me talk about you or with you, that you were probably one of the first people that I watched on YouTube and helped me develop my gifts just through your videos, because just you being yourself was such a breath of fresh air. And and before we started recording, we were talking about this, just people taking themselves too seriously with this stuff. And your videos just give people permission to, like, okay, you know, like, yeah, spirit is about flow and fun and joy. It's not, yes, about like, I'm doing this the right way or I'm not, you know, ruminating.
No, exactly. It's like, if you make it so serious, it's you're going to get blocked. I have a lot of people that come to me that when I ask spirit why they're blocked, spirit's like, they're so serious. It's like, you know, it's like, it's not like anything else. It's not like going to college or taking, you know, certain courses we do in life. It's so much about your energy. And like you said, about flow and having fun and enjoying the connection, you know, not getting ahead of it. So many people, it's like they're getting information, but they're ahead of themselves. They're ruminating, yes, you know, and it's like, it's, you know, spirit's trying to teach you to have a good time, yeah, enjoy this, you know, and have fun connecting with them, you know? Yeah. Yeah. Thank you though. Thank you for the compliments. And you've, you know, if, for the people that are listening, oh, and watching too, I forgot we're being recorded. Jen has helped me with my business and helped me tremendously. So you would be wise to also book with her, because she, you know, sometimes you need a consultant, you need an intuitive consultant to help you figure out the things in life and figure out things you're doing in your business. And I needed that. And Jen gave that to me. And it's helped so much the past few weeks. So thank you so much.
God. You're so welcome. Yeah. And I'll be putting up sessions soon. I'm still sort of,
yeah,
ruminating,
which is okay. You know, like, you and I are so hard on ourselves. I think about when we have to pause and sort of figure out our next steps. And so I want to tell everyone here, like, don't do what we do.
Don't be like us.
Don't be like us. Like, you know, it's always okay to take that pause. I've had to take it so many times in my business, and spirit will even go, hey, time to stop for a little bit. And I'm like, no, I just got going. And they're like, nope, we need you to learn some things. We need you to think about some things, you know, and yeah, allow new information to come to you. Your wants will change with what you offer, what, you know, it's like, just when you think you've got it figured out, you're always evolving. And that's okay.
Same. Yeah, it's okay. I mean, I literally like did an overhaul of my business like a month ago, and I'm like, yep, changing it. So yeah, it's okay. It's just gonna be.
Yeah, it's meant to. It's meant to. Yeah. Thank you though.
Thank you so much. This was awesome.
Oh, it was. And finally it worked out.
I know. We finally got it.
Mercury's no longer in Gatorade, as my husband says.
I love it. All right. Bye. Bye, everybody.
Bye, everyone. Thank you. You sit at the left side.
that the right side has to work hard all night. Maybe I think too much for my own good. Some people say so, other people say no, no. The fact is you don't think as much as you could. I had a childhood that was mercifully brief. I grew up in a state of disbelief. I started to think too much when I was 12, going on 13. Me and girls from St. Augustine, up in the mezzanine, thinking about God, yeah. Maybe I think too much. Just hold her, stop trying to mold.